Thank you for being here. It's the first time I'm talking under such a hard deadline. Usually my talks last for days, so I'll try and do my best. The change that I wish to present to you is a radical one. It's one that your minds will not accept readily, and I'm going to try to change that a bit. So I may not be able to break your box, but I'll certainly try to put a big crack in it. The change that I wish to propose to you is very simple, that nothing is incurable. Now that's something that your minds may not want to accept up front, but I can tell you that I've cured many incurable conditions in myself and in hundreds of people over the years. Migraines, for example, are incurable. I suffered from migraines for 15, 16, 18 years, and by the time I was in my mid-20s, my migraines used to hit me twice a month, 5 days each, like clockwork. I also healed a 16-year-old knee pain. My right knee hurt continuously for 16 years since I was a young boy. If I had to sit in an auditorium like this, I could only sit in the aisle chairs because I could stretch my leg. Because of my knee, I visited doctors in Delhi. I grew up here, all kinds of doctors, allopathic, homeopathic, Ayurvedic, Tibetan medicine, Irani medicine, you name it, I've tried it. Nothing helped. Then when I first discovered EFT, my 16-year-old knee pain vanished in 5 minutes. It's been 13 years, it hasn't come back. That's the moment that changed my life. That's when I learned more, that's when I understood that all healing is within me, and that there is nothing which is incurable. So, who here has migraines? Who would like to get rid of their migraines? Let me see your hands. Okay, healthy group, just one person with migraines. Okay, joint pains. Who would like to get rid of their joint pains? All right. Okay, I'm gonna get you all interested now. Who would like to get rid of their excess fat? See, now I have your attention. Okay, good, good. Backaches, who would like to get rid of their backaches? Good. And who would like to get rid of their husbands? All right, I'll tell you, you know, it works with that as well. I'm not joking. You know, we have amongst my students over the years, you'll find there is an elite group of women who I call the New Husband Society. And with the work that they've done, you know, I'm being very serious here, you know, with the work they've done, they've healed their relationship so much without saying a word to anyone that the guy looks the same, he has the same name, but he treats them like a queen. Okay? And that's not just true for one relationship. You can fix all your relationships without saying a word to the other person. It's all about fixing your relationship with yourself. So, before we understand how anything is unhealable, let me take you back to middle school. Any doctors here in the audience? Any medical doctors? I can't see well with these lights. No doctors here today? Oh, one. Good. So, I'd like you to tell me if any of the scientific, biological facts that I'm stating are incorrect, okay? And if they're correct, you can just listen along. So we all know, and we've learned it in middle school, that our brains control every organ of the body. True? Okay? So let me ask you, what happens with people like Christopher Reeve, if you remember? He became paralyzed when his spine broke. So with people whose necks break, spines break, and the central nervous system is completely disconnected from the brain, the brain cannot talk to any of the organs. Correct, doctor? How do the organs function? And how do they function in harmony with each other? Who's telling them what to do? How come the only function you lose when your brain is disconnected is voluntary muscle control? Your liver functions, your stomach, your eyes, your ears, everything functions. So all I'm saying is that medical science, biology, has given us some wonderful solutions. But perhaps there's more to it than meets the eye. And that missing piece, the big piece, is what I call energy. That's what I've discovered over the years. That we are primarily energy. And that energy is consciousness. That energy is intelligence. That energy knows how to fix things. That energy knew how to fix my knee pain. No doctor knew how to fix it. If we understand that we are energy, if we connect with the energy that we are, we can claim complete control of our life. How's that? Without having to look at anyone or anything. So the thing about energy is that we cannot see it. You cannot see sound, you cannot see heat, you cannot see light. But all energy has vibration, and vibration we can feel. So let's very quickly tune into our vibrations, because I want to at least have you leave here with a little knowledge of who you really are, that you are an energy being first, and how to become aware of that energy. Okay? So let's take a deep breath. Okay? And I'm going to say a statement. It's a very simple exercise. I want you to say the statement with as much clarity as you can. Okay? Just clarity. Say it out loud like you mean it. Okay? Ready? The success rate is 50%. Good. Now that has a feeling to it. If you miss the feeling, now we'll say the failure rate is 50%. Could you see a difference? Did one feel different from the other? That's vibration. Every word, every sentence, every thought, every action has a vibration, and that is what life responds to. That is what the universe responds to. Okay, so being aware of your vibration is critical to having a smooth life. But most of the time, we are not feeling good inside when we are doing things, and we manifest results that we don't want. Let's try another one, just to get you clear. Say, don't be late. Good. You really mean that, don't you? And now let's say, please be on time. Is there a difference in the feeling? That's what matters. Okay? It's very simple. That's what matters. And you can change that. So the beautiful thing about energy is that it's infinite. Again, going back to middle school, what did we learn about energy? That energy is, cannot be created or destroyed. Good. So what does that mean? That you can't use it. It's always there. It's infinite. So if it's infinite, you can't run out of it, which is a good thing because it's also inflation-proof. Very unlike the other forms of energy that you've been paying for these days. And it's free. So it never runs out, it's free, it's infinite, and you already have it. Okay, so a question that I'm going to ask you now, which I may answer later if you're good, is if you're infinite energy, why do you get tired? Now we are going to learn about another dimension of energy, again through experience. So I want you to pay attention, close your eyes, and think of a deep hurt that you experienced. Someone who hurt you, something very hurtful that happened. Or if you cannot think of a hurt, some guilt that you may be carrying. Or if you don't have hurt or guilt, you can connect with something or someone you're really afraid of. Think of any one of these things clearly. Just think, it won't take long. And as you're thinking, I want you to focus on your bodies, focus inside your bodies. And you'll be able to feel where this negative emotion is, where this pain is. You'll be able to feel the hurt, you'll be able to feel the fear or the guilt. It doesn't matter how long ago something happened, the blocked emotion is still there. You can feel the pain. Just become aware of the energy, of the vibration of it. Okay? Good. Take a deep breath, please. Keep your eyes closed. Now tilt your heads upward as if you were looking at the ceiling with your eyes closed. Okay? Put big, stupid smiles on your faces. Big smiles from one ear to the other. Okay? Don't be lazy now. Big smiles, because that's important for this exercise. I can see some of you are being very, very lazy about your smiles. You know, it doesn't cost anything. Big smiles, come on. Try to touch both your ears, okay? Open your eyes, take a deep breath, keep looking up with a big smile. Okay, feel how that smile feels in your body. Big, big smile, the biggest smile that you can. And feel how that energy is moving inside your body, okay? Sit straight, sit tall, take another deep breath, keep smiling just for 5 more seconds. Keep smiling, keep looking up and big smiles on your face. And try and think of that same hurt, that same fear, that same guilt, but do not stop smiling. That's very important. Try and get depressed. Try and feel hurt. But keep smiling. Okay, give God a nice big smile. Okay, if you cheat on the smile, it won't work. You have to smile. Okay, the biggest, stupidest smile that you can have. And think hard about who hurt you, who betrayed you, who you're scared of, and tell me if you can get depressed. Okay, you can take a deep breath, you can look down. Could any of you feel that hurt when you were smiling? No. What does that tell you? So we learned a couple of things here. One of the main problem areas for us is emotions. That's why it's called emotional freedom techniques. And most of us don't even know what an emotion is, do we? Does anyone know what an emotion is? Okay, where did you read that? Someone told you, probably one of my students. Any other ideas? What are examples of emotion? Fear. What else? Anger, joy, happiness. So what I'm asking is, what's common between love and hate? Joy and sadness. And what we've experienced, I'm sorry? I didn't hear. Emotion of devotion. Even devotion is an emotion. So what I'm really asking you is that what's common between love and hate? And that's something I've already given you the answer to. Emotion, as you've just experienced, is nothing but energy in motion. Isn't that what happened just now? When you experienced a negative emotion, did it not feel stuck? Couldn't you not feel the energy in your body? You could, isn't it? How many of us could? All of us, isn't it? And when you smiled, it began moving. What happened to it when it smiled? It began to expand, didn't it? Didn't you feel that expansion? So what's an emotion? An emotion simply tells you whether your energy is blocked or not. That's where emotions are your friends. That's where pain is your friend, because blocked energy causes pain. It's not what someone said, it's not anything else. It's just when your energy gets blocked, you will feel pain, because there is nothing more important than to keep your energy flowing. That's why we've been designed with this system. If your energy remains blocked for a long time, you will get depressed. You will become psychotic if it's strong enough. You will get sick more than anything else. It will get stuck in your body. It will manifest physically. It's all a function of energy. If your energy is high enough, then your immunity will be very high. Then nothing will make you sick. Then you won't attract any negative outcomes in your life. But without fixing energy, you keep blocking energy as you go through life. Your energy levels drop. That's why you get tired, even though you have infinite energy. Okay? So the wonderful thing, like we said about energy, is that it's infinite. You have it. And now with a tool like EFT, you can clear it. Okay? Before, you knew all this. What was the biggest source of problems in your life? That you couldn't control your emotions. You got upset when you didn't want to get upset. You lost your temper when you didn't want to. You kept hurting when you wanted to come out of hurt. You get afraid when you don't want to be afraid. And you wish certainly people around you control their emotions, don't you? They may wish the same thing about you sometimes. So if you didn't know emotions are energy, and if you didn't know you could control them, and you still perhaps don't know how to control them, you will have emotional problems. But solving them is not difficult. Okay, if you know how. If you know this tool called EFT, Emotional Freedom Techniques, which is very, very simple. I don't have enough time to teach it here. I need at least a day or two. But at least you know that there is an option. So how have you been trying to control your emotions? By controlling your husbands and wives, isn't it? If you do this, I'll be angry. If you do this, I'll be happy. And what does that lead to? Even more anger and frustration, doesn't it? So what's the solution? The solution is to keep your energy clear. Can you hear me? So, what is emotional freedom techniques? Emotional freedom techniques is a healing technique which was developed in California in the early 90s, where you just tap on certain energy points like that. And just by doing that, you can clear energy. There's a little more to it than that. And once you clear your energy, you'll be able to reclaim your inner peace. Okay? And that's really all you want in life. You want happiness, you want peace. You don't want to do anything else, or you don't do anything else for any other reason. So if you take control of your energy, if you can learn this technique called EFT, you'll be in complete control. You'll be able to sail through any situation in life. You will not be upset or anxious, except, of course, when you're watching India play South Africa at the World Cup. That I can't help you with. Okay? Anything else, you'll be able to clear with the EFT. Okay? Thank you very much. You've been a great audience.